the PI ping interface. The ping interface will simply measure latency of network connections by sending and measuring standard ping requests. This can be really helpful in identifying where your network is slower or even when a device is down. In ICU, there is only one parameter that is interface specific, the timeout. By default set to 3 seconds, can accept values up to 1 hour 3600. In the bat file, that corresponds to /TO. But in ICU, as you can see here, if you want to change the default to 3 seconds, you simply check this checkbox and then enter your number of seconds. This could be useful on a slower network, where you already know you will receive ping times higher than 3 seconds. To configure ping tags, all numerical types are accepted. You could simply use float 32, which is the most popular one. The point source should be set to whatever character you specified in ICU. By default, the point source for piping is J. The most important field in this interface is instrument tag. This is where you specify the host name or IP address to be pinged. Then, we recommend setting the step attribute to on or 1, the span to 10,000, the engineering units to MS, or whatever abbreviation of milliseconds you can think of. As for location codes, location 1 is always the one where the interface ID number is specified. Remember in the previous chapter, we talked about location 4, which should be set to one of the scan classes that is specified in the interface. Location 5 here determines whether debugging is enabled or not. This will send more messages in the log file. And finally, location 2 and 3, which are optional, are to determine the number of ping requests to send and the minimum number of valid ping replies before to calculate an average and archive it. Let me show you how you would configure a ping tag in the Point Builder plugin in System Management Tools. The System Management Tools can be opened from the Start menu. Start menu, Programs, PI System, System Management Tools. When open, you can simply go under Points in Point Builder, where you type a name for your tag, something like ping, and then the name of the device you ping, mail server 2, for example. The point source should be set to J, because J is the one we set in ICU in the general tab. You see, this was in the previous chapter. Back to Point Builder. Point source was set to J. Engineering units are MS. Then we go on the classic tab, so we can set location codes. Location 1 is the interface ID number. Again, back to ICU. I can see my interface ID number is 1. So location 1 should be set to 1. Location 4 should be set to the number of the scan class you want to use. Back to ICU. We can see we have 2 scan classes. Do you want to scan for your mail server's response time every 1 minute or every 5 minutes? 1 or 2? Let's say every 1 minute. Scan class number 1. And the last required field for the PI ping tags is instrument tag, where you should put the IP address or the name of the device to ping. Something like 192.168.0.122. When this is done, you can simply click on Save. And in up to 2 minutes, the interface will monitor for PI point changes and then see this tag. After it picked up the tag, it will send ping requests to the server and then archive the results. So a quick recap of tag configuration. Some name, engineering units, point source J, ID number in location 1, scan class number in location 4, and the IP address or the host name in instrument tag. When configuring piping tags, the extended descriptor XDesk field contains additional settings to determine behavior of tags. You could consult interface specific documentation to know more about that. But as an example, you could in XDesk have out ADDR equals some IP address. That would tell the piping interface to use this specific network card when two or more of them are on the same subnet. In addition to this setting, you can determine the size of the ping packet to send. See, you could use data size equals a number of bytes in order to change the default or 48 bytes of random data sent in by the piping interface. Again, you should consult ping interface documentation to know more about all the settings you can use in ping tags. For those of you who have access to the regular IT monitor class manual as well as a piping interface, you could go for exercise number 12,